Welcome back to MMA Al Dente. I'm here to talk about Raul Rosas Jr. versus Ricky Tercios. For this fight, I'm actually going with Ricky Tercios. My heart's not totally into it, but he is my pick to win this fight. I settled on that before I saw the odds. And having seen the odds, of course, he's my bet, but I'm not in love with it. My reason for picking against Raul Rosas Jr. is his one glaring loss, his one loss in which he was fading big time against Christian Rodriguez and was outpointed down the stretch. His wrestling was no longer there for him, and he looked a little lost. He did a good job surviving, but he did not do a good job adapting. And even though he's only 18 or whatever, 19 years old, whatever he is, he's a fucking teenager, and he's going to look a lot better someday soon. But he's still in that teenage phase. He's not that far removed from that big loss to Christian Rodriguez. And I think Ricky Tercios, who is probably in his prime, I've seen him beat a lot of great fighters. He is a very durable guy. I expect him not to get finished to Raul Rosas Jr. And I think he's a guy that thrives on fun back and forth, scrambly grappling bouts. And I think he's going to be given one here against Raul Rosas Jr. So he's my pick to win. But I'm aware that Raul Rosas Jr. is such a dominant grappler where even if he loses 2-1, there's still a chance he got a 10-8 round in that first round. And I'm assuming it's round one that he won. But I am still picking Ricky Tercios. I think Ricky Tercios is precisely that kind of wily grappler that will give Raul Rosas Jr. fits. I think Raul Rosas Jr. is still the dominant grappler between the two of them, and I think he's much better early on than probably fucking anybody. But I think he's going to have a hard time putting away Ricky Tercios, who's only been put away once, and it was a big punch to Manny Martinez. And Raul Rosas Jr., despite his recent success against Terrence Mitchell, he's much more of a grappling threat. I'm sure his hands are developing, but I'd be really surprised if he did anything significant on the feet against Ricky Tercios. Ricky Tercios, he's a formidable striker, but he as well, his grappling is what's going to win him this fight, and specifically his pace. I mean, the guy's a good striker as well, but I think he's going to have to make this an exerting fight for Raul Rosas Jr., and be the fresher man down the stretch. And that's what I'm picking him to do. Ricky Tercios has scratched and clawed for decision victories over really good fighters. Kevin Natividad in his most recent performance, which I thought he would have looked a little better in that fight, but he was given a tough fight, ripped to the mat many times, and had an answer every time. And he definitely got the better of him by the end of that fight. Well, I shouldn't say definitely, but I thought he won. And against Brady Hystan in the ultimate finale, that was another 3-round decision. Razor-thin fight, but Ricky Tercios showed he can go hard. Ricky Tercios also had 2 decision wins on the Ultimate Fighter that are exhibitions. Ludovic Shalinian and also, you know, the guy. Who the fuck? Dan Argueta, current UFC fighter. And he was able to outpoint both of them. I trust Ricky Tercios more. I think Raul Rosas Jr. has steamrolled everybody. And the one guy he didn't really steamroll is Mando Gutierrez on the Contender Series. Mando, who was on the Ultimate Fighter last season. And he dominated Mando. And I thought he looked really good down the stretch. Even Mando kind of took him down at the beginning of round 3. And he took that away pretty quickly and went back to dominating. But in a fight where he's pushed and he's not able to dominate, I'm expecting the wheels to come off, at least at this point, again, because despite him having plenty of time to develop in the future, he's still stuck as the same fighter that he was pretty much when he lost to Christian Rodriguez last year. So Ricky Tercios is the pick. I think he has a tough time underneath Raul Rosas Jr. early, but then starts getting up, getting out scrambling Raul Rosas Jr., taking away the wrestling altogether, and being the fresher man down the stretch. Pretty much wins a very similar type of fight that Christian Rodriguez won. That's my pick, and my bet, but I'm not in love with it again because Raul Rosas Jr. is so dominant where he's halfway to a 10-8 before you know it. And also Ricky Tercios, he's had some flat performances as of late. You know, The Kevin Nativi-Dodd fight I thought was close. I thought he didn't look as good as I expected him to look, but he still performed well in the end, I guess. And the Ayman Zahabi fight especially, he was flat for that one. That was more reminiscent of his other decision loss, the Boston Salmon, it's actually Salmon, on the Contender Series years back. But I don't envision him losing that fight to Raul Rosas Jr. Again, Raul Rosas Jr., I'm sure he's getting more comfortable by the day on the feet, but I think he's got underdeveloped striking, and the grappling is where it's going to be at for him. And I think it will be there for him early, but not throughout the whole fight. Ricky Tercios by decision is the pick. I'll wait to see the props, but right now with the money lines being the only thing available, plus 205 for Ricky Tercios was worth a small bet for me. Like, share, subscribe, all that horse shit, and check out my other videos.